Hello, so welcomes back everyone. AnthWolf here, continuing with even more Star Wars The Old Republic, playing as Morathi, my Sith Sorceress, here on the world of Tatooine, where we're searching for the fourth artifact of Tulak Horde. We have now been joined by Andronicus Revel, who promises to hand the artifact over to us if we help him get revenge on his former first mate, this Sylas Wilkes, who I believe is currently working for the Exchange. Well, I say that Andronicus will give us the artifact. Sylas and the artifact should hopefully be in the same location, so it benefits us both to track Sylas down. So, we are here in Mos Eila, and before we find Sylas' current base, we're heading over to an outpost in Jundland to help out Darth Sliverin, I believe his name is. Silfar, sorry, Sliverin. A bit Harry Potter there. Darth Silvar, yes, who is looking for relics, artifacts that were abandoned by Zerka Corporation. Now, you'll have to forgive me this afternoon. I've had to turn my tower fan on once again. It is absolutely melting, so that might come through the microphone. If so, I apologize. It can't be helped. Bloody hell. We are already quite far into our progress towards our weekly conquest reward. Not bad. Not bad at all. Is there a mailbox down here? Yes, there is, because someone has sent us a bit of mail. Ah, there it is. Ah, Darth Seraphin. That is a name that will come up later, I believe. I understand you were recently involved in the discovery of Force-sensitive Jawas. Furthermore, I understand that Lord Burra attempted to conceal this new threat in a misguided attempt to uphold Sith supremacy. Let me assure you that you acted wisely, and that Lord Burra will be punished when she returns to me. Oh, Lord Burra might be an apprentice under Darth Seraphin, then. The Empire will never triumph if we refuse to acknowledge our enemy's strengths. You have earned my respect, and perhaps we shall meet someday. Let me have a look at Darth Seraphim, because I believe he... I wonder if he's a member of the Dark Council. And if so, what sphere of power does he have? It doesn't say he was a member of the Dark Council. Hmm. Oh well. Could have double checked these things. So we know who is in contact with us.
Displaying all authorized destinations.
Okay, to Outpost Verath.
Travel route is confirmed.
You normally need to take a speeder, a taxi service to various outposts, not all of them, but there are certain places on Tatooine you can't travel without taking the taxi service, because you'll be traveling through the deep desert, and you would start suffering from extreme dehydration, and you would start losing health over time until you died. There is a good chance, well, no, there would be a possibility of encountering a member of the Republic here, as both areas of Jundland, I think, are connected. After all, players of the Republic are usually up here. The chances are we won't encounter anyone up until we enter the Doom Sea, if there's anyone around, that is. Either way, let's see if Darth Sylvar is back from his pilgrimage.
This is Captain Gola, Reclamation Service Outpost 701. It's good to see you, my lord. My team's still searching for the Zerka base, but we've hit a snag that, frankly, we can't handle ourselves.
Fill me in on the situation.
After you left for the Jawas, Lord Sylvar had a vision. Something about the natives, the Sand People. He flew a speeder into the Dune Sea, but we lost the tracking signal in an energy storm. Sylvar was summoning lightning.
Darth Sylvar is a Sith Lord. You needn't worry about his safety.
That's what I told the others. But Sylvar wouldn't call on that much power unless he was desperate. Lord Sylvar was following a dream, the same way he found the lost temple of Zeost and the crystal caves of Molovar. He told me the Sand People and their spirit guides were the key. He was looking for some sort of compass.
The natives, what are they? What could they do to Sylvar?
I don't know. They're savages. Still, I wouldn't think they could kill him alone. Find the spirit guides and find him. When you have answers, come to our forward outpost. Otherwise, I don't know how this mission can succeed.
Okay. I don't think Lord Sylvar managed to reach the Dune Sea. After all, he's actually to the east rather than the west. But we will certainly go looking for him. We have an astromech droid that wants to tell us about the Flashpoint Mandalorian Raiders. Let's not worry about that so much.
Do you require medical attention? Be well.
And we do have an exploration mission here from Teek.
Nebaga imana, naki naya, bila maknam unya kamna lebek. Naya memgem kaligam, gegwa nam karak naya memak. Kam inu nemuk, naja naya akam memnik miraka.
I have no idea what you're saying.
Memundia nepepjang, hapakra wama nimpam. Laporam amka, mamni nikag, nagnaya mamni kambram. Kala jiwa nimok. Ebemgam nyama naya aigam.
By all means, continue.
Nulilak apa jam kamgram. Amka nem nang nemua inuk. Memgam gamgi, nina gegwan. Am nerna hanak. Nemua bemguana. Kumia yang memgamba paka.
So Teek is pretty much calling us stupid. He doesn't want to go into how it works, he just believes we want to know what it does. Right. So if we charge this oscillator up, this destabilizer, we can then weaken droids so they can be destroyed in a single blaster hit. Interesting. It's only useful against, like, the Jawas and such, who rely a lot on their droids. I suppose we could certainly look into it. Oh, hello. It's a heroic mission.
Get a shuttle out here to evac the wounded. Corpses stay till we've assessed the threat condition. Now! Don't stand there like some drooling sand rat! You're an Imperial soldier!
I'm sorry you had to see this, my lord. Not one of our army's finer moments.
What fools attack the Imperial Army?
Well-armed fools, courtesy of the Exchange. Ever run into them? Nasty crime syndicate likes to use Tatooine as a waypoint. These criminals don't want this rock under Imperial control, so they've been stirring up local resistance.
What exactly happened here?
The Exchange has been using these caravans to supply the insurgency and keep it active. Every one is guarded by these exchange tuskers. They're too big to hurt and too dumb to scare, so each one we take down costs us. I was about to tell Command we'd need a new combat battalion if we want to take them on, but any chance you'd like to lend some expertise?
No petty criminals can be allowed to tie the hands of the Empire.
You want to help? Go follow the caravan routes and take down as many as you can. The locals will assume the exchange abandoned them. Then we'll see how quickly those puddle farmers beg us to take them over.
Okay. So let's have a look at this. We must destroy the caravan ammunition stockpile. That's just to the north. Well, we could certainly look into that. Oh, bloody hell. I almost engaged a Scribbin and realized they're all elite enemies. Holy hell. Wow. Okay, this is actually a lot more difficult than I expected. Right, yeah. Need to maybe pick our battles here.
Shooting.
So we have a bonus to defeat 6 of the exchange forces. Definitely powerful. There's the ammunition stockpile. Let's finish. Oh, even though that was quite a few of the exchange, they didn't all count towards the. Yeah, this guard didn't go towards the bonus. When you have a companion set as a DPS role, they have an ability, for Andronicus here, it's the Deadeye Double Shot. When an enemy's health is below 30%, they use an ability which does a shit ton of damage. I mean, these guys only have, well, just under 8,000 health. And, well, basically if they go beyond 30% health, they're dead. Pretty much instantly. Okay, the next stage is to destroy 4 speeders and 5 caravan supplies. Works out extremely well since we actually cleared out the exchange members around these pavilions. Well, tents, I suppose. Okay. You know, we just need to defeat 8 more of the exchange. We can do that. Again, not all of them count, but that's fine. We'll make it work. shield for a moment. Just to heal ourselves up. We're just waiting for more of the exchange to respawn back next to the tents, but we'll deal with this group. Good. More the exchange are respawning. If we deal with this sentinel, then deal with these three, that should be it. Heal ourselves up and deal with the last group then. I mean, there is a sentinel just patrolling there, but hey, why not?
Without the support of the exchange, this planet will be swearing allegiance to the Emperor before you can say aerial bombardment.
Okay, that's our bonus mission. Sorry, that's our heroic mission complete. Oh, hello. Two Imperial agents also involving themselves. Okay. Let's go play with that destabilizer. Oh, forgive me. Feeling a little, actually, a little fatigued, a little tired. Before we play with these droids, let's find this, solar array. There it is. Now we must destroy 8 shielded junk droids. Huh. We're actually in another heroic area. Hmm. So, let's go find Darth Sylvar. Is Darth or Lord? Darth Sylvar. Right, we need to travel through a cave system. Oh, so there's a base for the exchange somewhere nearby. Oh, hello. as we go through the Shattered Basin tunnel here. We have a small base of operations. Plenty of sand people. So we need to locate a sand person guide and find a compass to find their find one of their cave entrances. Yeah, we can use this compass. And we find, a spirit cave where we'll find Darth Sylvar. First things first, though, we have a staged bonus mission once again. First stage is to defeat 20 sand people. Gift there. Okay, so far, so good. I'm sure the second stage of the bonus mission is to also defeat so many of the sand people. There's stage one complete. Stage two is to defeat 40 sand people. Which is quite a few, holy hell. We actually have a sand people camp nearby.
Give me your best shot!
We'll head on our way towards the camp. Plenty of sand people for us to kill nearby. Yeah, we'll fight our way through the camp. You're gonna have to come in here for the other stages of the bonus mission. Well, may as well make a start now. The cave we need to go in is just to the south, but moment. Okay, Right, we've killed most of the sand people in the camp, and it still wasn't enough, so let's backtrack a little. Might as well enjoy the spoils of our victory. What does this look like? Not really all I see ourselves wearing.
Right between the eyes. I love this.
Right, we're slaughtering plenty of sand people. We need two more. You'll do.
Right between the eyes. I love this.
Happy days. That's stage two complete. Stage three. We must poison the sand people's water supply. Oh, these enemies respawned extremely quickly. Perfect. So they said we were just carrying poison with us, but we're Sith, sure, why not? In here. Andronicus, why don't you deal with him? Well, I pour some poison in here. Thank you. Stage 3 complete. The final stage is to defeat Kotawa the Huntmaster and secure proof of the deed. What are we taking as proof? We are taking his prized hunting trophy. It is unclear what kind of animal it came from, but it is undeniably precious to the slain hunter, who held it tightly even in death. Right, time to get the hell out of here. Uh-oh. Right, see if we can find Darth Sylvar. And we believe, using the compass, this is also the way he went.
Shooting.
And our fellow Sith is having a bit of a nap, it seems.
Lord Sylthar.
Did Captain Connor send you? Such a good man. Eh? A pity he didn't send young Hale, but the honor is yours. You will hear my last words.
Tell me what's been done to you.
The Force called me into the desert. I sensed what Circa found. An alien power. I saw a white room. I thought the Sand People would know the land's secrets. I murdered them. Stole their thoughts to find this cave. I knew victory before they destroyed me.
I followed the Shaman's compass. But what is this place?
It is a cave of secrets. My journey here was not for nothing. Circa built its base over a site from the natives' myths. A forbidden land. The paintings in the cave show the way. Find them. Record them. Gola and his men, they...
Your journey's over, Lord Sylthar.
Find the paintings. But beware. Beware the thing in the white room.
Beware the thing in the white room. Okay. We'll certainly keep that in mind. Seems those are the paintings we're looking for, the murals. Can't understand exactly what that tells us, but hopefully Lord Sylphar's reclamation team will know more or can decipher it. After recording the image, it would be easy to destroy the piece and prevent anyone else from viewing it. We may as well just upset everyone today. Okay, we can return to the outpost. We may as well quick travel there. Oh, I totally forgot to mention we have been world synced to level 29.
Your device worked well. The droids are destroyed.
Mamni lebek bak manuk. Meraka naja ki namabamyak. Bragam nemya, inu buyin. A kamamka amkananya.
It is. Oh. Went from 71 to 73 because we completed. How much experience did we gain there? Something's not right. What? I guess I can't complain, hey. Because how much experience was that? Did we just gain maybe 1.5 million? And I don't think we picked up that much experience, but... Sure, why not? So again, we get some material gathering decorations for our stronghold, if we had one. Some exotic crafting material. Some certificates we can sell for credits. And some assorted scrap, which you can use at the Scrap Peddler, who was in the Cartel Bazaar on the Imperial Fleet. Where the hell? Um I mean, fair enough, we got that from completing Teek's quest, but where the hell did we get... Oh, well. Let's not think about it, my head will just explode. So, they can be stored away at some point. All this stuff can be sold. Those are companion gifts. Okay. So, there is another outpost on the way to Wilkes Base and a Captain Golar and the Reclamation Team's base of operations. So I guess we'll head to the next outpost.
Do you require medical attention? Be well.
Okay, let's be on our way. How are we doing for gold? Credits, I should say. Gold. I can't even blame myself for saying I've been playing too much Final Fantasy XIV, because that's kill. What was I using gold in? You know what? I don't know. It just popped into my head. Either way, let's head on to the next outpost. I thought we were actually going to have to travel up this ramp, up this incline, and I thought Wilkes Base would have been up here, but instead, there is, as mentioned, an underground base of operations. There's an underground compound in the bottom corner of the map. First things first, cross over here. I have been over this way as a player of the Republic. I had to be very careful in sneaking past some of the NPC guards. As I say, there is a base of operations here. It is possible, though. So this is Mos Anek. There's another heroic mission, two exploration missions. Tell you what, we'll do the two exploration missions, and then go hit the exchange compound.
Wow, I bet you don't need a cannon to flatten a bunker. Still, this might interest you. Navy just deployed the next generation prototype of our top orbital strike weapon. She's a real beauty, let me tell you. I'm supposed to be overseeing test firing against hard targets in the area, but we're on indefinite standby until conditions improve.
Why the hesitation?
The exchange is seriously entrenched out here, but they're protecting their strongholds with a wide area signal jammer. It means our targeting systems are useless, even the handheld close-up targeters.
Sounds like you'd have to get close to your targets either way.
Yeah, it's not a problem for you though, right? Once that jammer's out of commission, we can blow up anything we want, anytime we want. You with me on this? You could be the first to debut this beauty's 10 kiloton Roth.
Any idea where I should start?
The exchange leaders are the only ones with access to the jammer. Their security spikes would let you shut it down. With the jammer out of commission, you can use this targeter to blow any exchange assets in the area sky high. Hit anything you can get in range of. Bigger the better, just don't stand too close. I'll look forward to the light show.
It just so happens the signal jammer is down next to Wilkes Base anyway. So it all works out quite nicely. Oh, hello. We have a law object on the Imperial Reclamation Service. If we were so interested. Oh. Oh, that's the heroic mission. Derp. Hello, Lieutenant.
Oh, my lord. My lord, it's so good you're here. Band of filthy jowers cracked into one of the Zerka Corporation's abandoned compounds we recently unearthed. Made off with every droid in the place.
And you expect me to help?
The Jowers may have foiled the ideal recovery of these artifacts, but that doesn't mean the Empire can't still benefit from the technology. You see, the stolen droids activated. Now they're systematically hunting down everything around the Jowers' derelict sandcrawler. I've observed their behaviors becoming refined, more efficient. Honestly, it looks like they're learning from trial and error.
That's somewhat intriguing.
If these droids are adaptive and self-coordinating, their applications would be innumerable. Scanning the architecture of the droids' memory cores should give us more insight into their uniform design and their individual differences. Can the Reclamation Service count on your support?
Somebody needs to find out what's going on here.
It's unlikely that the droids will stand idle while you attempt to take a reading. Disabling them will be necessary. Just try not to damage their memory cores while you're taking the fight out of them.
When you say taking the fight out of them... Yeah, you can only destroy... Only scan a destroyed aberrant droid. Okay. So we are getting ever close to the current level cap, which I believe is still level 75. And after that, then we'll unlock... Oh, bloody hell. Sand people trying to make an ambush. And after that, we'll unlock... What was it called again? Is this... Is it actually Conquest levels? You know what? It's been so long I can't remember. I can find out though. Is it Renown? Well, we'll find out. Ooh, hello. Oh! People are fighting the Tatooine world boss. On each world, in fact, we haven't even talked about this, bloody hell. On each world, there is what they call a world boss, who pretty much you can't take on alone. And at a low level, like at level 29 when you're meant to be here, it would give you a debuff where you'd pretty much be broken in terror. You wouldn't be able to do anything to it. To be honest, even at level 73, because we've been level synced, I think we'd still be suffering that debuff, and I don't think we could deal with Trapjaw. But I do know where Trapjaw is. Anyhow, so we need to scan a few of these droids. So the memory core was damaged on one. We managed to get the scan on the other two. Let's see if we can get any more scans complete. No. No. Yeah, that's three. Right, we need one more decent scan. Hey, perfect. Right, we need to find... It's not the technicians. The weapon specialists.
Right between the eyes. I love this.
It's the weapon specialists who may have the data spikes to shut down the... The signal jammer. do have a bonus to defeat 15 of the exchange forces. So we may as well involve ourselves. Security chest while we're here, thank you. Companion gift, some crafting materials. What I need, perfect. Right, where is... Ah, okay, it's just outside. No, it's not. It's over here. There we are. Where is the comm relay? Oh, that is just outside. Time to go. Happy days! Okay, and since we're here, let's go retrieve our artifact, shall we? Sky Princess Mutineers. Andronicus, was your ship called the Sky Princess? It's not the sort of name I would have expected for a feared pirate, I have to say. Speaking of, level 73, ooh, hello. A new ability. I did not expect us to have a new one. Let's have a look. Vault Rush. Deals a small amount of energy damage to your target and leaves you feeling energized. This energized effect can stack twice, and each stack increasing Vault Rush's damage by 30%. This ability has 3 charges and recharges every 10. Okay. So... Right, okay. So you can use it 3 times, but each stack increases its damage. Right, interesting. Where the hell do I put this then? I could replace Jolt, I suppose. Put it over there. Right, so let's give this a go. It'd be good for single targets. Yeah.
blast Wilkes to pieces just as soon as we find him.
Ah, perfect. Well, you found him now.
Well, well, Andronicus Revel. I'm surprised they let you out of Imperial prison. And you brought a Sith to help you. How cute. But see these guys? They'll crush you and your Sith.
You're only making this more painful for yourself.
Let me guess. You're here for the artifact. The one the Empire was so keen on getting just before I crushed Andronicus. Would you believe he called me a nobody? A worthless, mangy, skinny little nobody? So I took his ship, his crew, his cargo, his blasters, and what else? Oh, his girl. Who's nobody now, Nikki?
I'm gonna rip out your throat and laugh while you try to scream.
I must know where the artifact is first.
You'll never beat me, and you'll never get your artifact. Boys, kill the Sith, but keep Andronicus alive. I'll want to play with him a little longer.
This never ends the way you want it to.
Idiots! You'll never get it now. Not the artifact, not the blasters, nothing.
I think we knocked the sense out of him.
You're so stupid. The great Andronicus Revel chases me across five planets only to fail. Even gets a Sith on his side, and they both fail.
Talk sense.
The artifact, it's cursed. It's cursed.
Yeah, I figured that one out.
They took it, just like I took it from you. Took it all. The blasters, the artifact, the money.
I have no idea what you're saying.
The men I sent to guard the cargo, the artifact made them mad, and they took it. They took all of it. You'll never get to them. They went out into the deep desert. They left weeks ago. The sand people will eat you before you ever catch them.
I've heard enough. Now give me one good reason not to blast your teeth through the back of your skull.
Do it. Maybe he'll finally shut up.
I've been waiting to do this for a long time, Wilkes. Can't say it was nice knowing you either.
I have no regrets, Andronicus. Least of all this.
You missed his face.
Idiot. Lost your artifact and my special-made blasters. Just wait until I get my blaster pointed at those thieves.
Exactly how deep into the desert do we have to go?
Well, there's a speeder that'll take us out so far, but the coordinates Wilkes had are a little further out than that. Come on, the sooner we get out there, the better chance we have of showing them thieves what's what.
Ah, delightful. Ooh, hello. Right, what does this chess piece look like? Okay, we've seen similar before. Ah, sorry, sneezing away again, bloody hell. Right. I don't mind that armor set, actually. Not too bad. Either way, let's get out of this base now. Where's our quick travel? Back to Mos Anek. Speak to the specialist and lieutenant once again, and then we're on our way to Captain Golar. So, Sylas trusted some of his men with the artifact, with the blasters, with some money, seemingly. And the artifact apparently also drove them mad to betray him, just as he betrayed Andronicus.
That was great! I can see those strikes come down from here! After that display, I'm going to recommend the final model be named in your honor.
I'd like to hang on to this targeter for a while.
Addictive, isn't it? I'm afraid the prototype wasn't intended for sustained use. We'll be collecting the Delta A5 soon to make adjustments based on the data you provided. Here's a little something on behalf of the project. It's been a pleasure.
Okay. So we did finish, yeah. Oh well. We need to wait another week. So be it.
You've brought me readings? Excellent. It looks like you were able to conduct many scans. Did the droids pose much of a threat when you encountered them?
It was actually quite simple.
Truly? Perhaps we should have left them to mature a bit longer. But we can observe prototypes built from this data. You've ensured that Tatooine will hold no secrets from the Empire. Thank you.
Not a problem. Right, anything else we need to do? Not really.
A healthy customer is a spending customer. Watch yourself out there.
Right, let's have a look. What time do we have? Right. Decisions. Yeah, let's go a little bit further. Head on towards the Imperial's reclamation base that they built out of the cliffside. Hand in the prized hunting trophy from the staged bonus mission. Today's a level 74. One more level to go. Right, let's go deliver the bad news to Captain Golar about Darth Sylvar.
Check on Keeler and the others. See if they figured out anything with the artifact.
Sir, I'd like to hear what happened.
Follow orders. I'll brief everyone later. I've sent for water and Calto, my lord. I'm sure the desert was agonizing, but we've been waiting for word. Any sign of Darth Sylvar?
Your master was Sith until the end. It was a good death.
So, he really didn't make it then. Damn it. We all felt it, but we weren't sure. We're not blasted Sith. Without Sylvar, we're just archaeologists with guns. Without him, this whole expedition falls apart.
It isn't over yet. I know where to find the Zerka base.
What are you talking about?
Ha ha ha!
Captain Gola.
Blast Hale, now's not the time.
The artifact. The one the Jawas found. It's got Kayla. We disabled the dampeners, and there was a flash.
What? Start containment procedures now.
Again, a test of Vertini.
Tell me about the imprisoned one.
Kabies metete for first, yanteto gise.
Killer? Everyone, stay back.
Jarrusted, yes. Tekesh marwar.
Oh, great. Okay, so Keela managed to break the stasis ward around that artifact that we saw in the locked crate. It didn't go very well.
Those creatures, they were my team.
Sir, I think Perrin escaped. He was heading into the desert toward the tribal settlement.
Blast, we'll mourn later. You remember the sons of Palawa. You hit them hard in Mos Ila. But their main village is just a few clicks out. If that creature reaches them, this could get very ugly.
What makes you say that?
Basic rule of xenoarchaeology. You don't unleash a foreign technology into a population center, especially one with a man-machine interface. Worst case, the technology that changed Perrin could replicate. Every person in the settlement could be transformed.
Fools shouldn't meddle with what they don't understand.
With due respect, my lord, we know what we are doing. There are risks to any excavation. Reclamation Service protocol for contaminated sites mandates atomic heat cleansing of everything within a 100-meter radius. We've got a store of baradium explosives for that purpose. Enough to obliterate the Sun's cave village. But I hope it won't come to that.
What choice do we have?
If you're lucky, maybe you can take out Perrin before he reaches the settlement. Otherwise, plant the explosives, be careful with them, around the caves. One way or another, the contamination has to be eliminated.
Okay, yeah. We need to chase down another one of these transform reclamation members. Hopefully before he reaches the Sons of Palara's main settlement. Tribal village. It's buried into the cliff face, similar to the reclamation outpost. Let's see if they know anything about our missing Imperial.
You. I knew the Empire used dishonorable tactics, but the ghost of the desert, do you know what it does to people?
What do you mean, ghost of the desert?
An old Jawa legend, a myth that kills with a touch. Within the first minute, that terror changed good villagers into murderous machines. There's a war going on in these caves. Now I'll give my brothers the chance to win by keeping you from interfering.
You'll die, along with everyone else in this village.
Ah, for Palawa, I'll fight until our blood becomes an oasis.
Okay, so we could have offered to,
How's this?
best for shooting.
Help him deal with Perrin. But let's be sure that no one's going to escape. We do need to go into the cave to plant one of the explosives. So we have to defeat some non-infected Palara, defeat some of the infected tribesmen, and defeat the transformed Perrin for the bonus mission. Some friends coming to say hello. So, the infected and transformed Imperials were talking about the imprisoned one. Oh, there's Perrin. The imprisoned one who came from the White Room. Who we were warned about from, Darth Sylvar. Well, there's Perrin. Dealt with. Let's plant our explosive. Gotta make sure they don't get close to us. They may have a stunning skill, which would be frustrating to say the least. Okay. So all of the infected individuals dealt with. Let's just make sure that none of them have slipped out of the cave here. Plant this last explosive. And time to get the hell out of here. Yep. Before we go back to Captain Gola, in here is a familiar face. We have Jeek.
Ripognani kari mariaka. Akam jalebik memarik.
Memuka halal familiar.
Niknurga nalo nemneraka. Bragam nemya inubuyen. Akamaka amkananya.
Haven't we had this conversation once already?
Mem ilik meraka. Nayanaram. Kam kalu amikmanik.
Either there are a lot of Nemoidians with attitudes around here, or you've got a serious memory problem.
Nebaga imana, naki naya, bila maknam unya kamna lebek. Nempanu koragen, pemguana nemu kamime. Manub meraka naja, kinamabam, yak manala.
What exactly does this entail?
Beraka karam kara, ninyamok. Ora mag yang megik. Kamperem ganyam baji yang. Manik hikum bukam.
So, we now have a memory core stabilizer, which will allow us to control erratic assassin droids. But we will have to reduce their health to below half. Awkward, but we'll make it work. Okay, that's three, and here's a four. There we are. Perfect. It's nice and easy.
I've finished testing. Your device works.
Naya memgem kaligam. Gegwa nam karak naya memak. Mamni lebek bak manuk. Meraka naja ki nama bamyak. Gagi ne paninu, am kambina bek nemu kemgram.
So kind of him not to mention the potential side effects of his device failing. If a hand had worked out, it would have killed us. Great, it would have blew our hand off at the very least. I need that hand. Right, I wonder, Captain Gola heard the explosions. This base is relatively close by.
The power reading's stable.
Yes, sir. The stasis field's online.
Keep it that way. I don't want the artifact powering up again.
I heard the explosion. I take it the contamination site's been cleared?
The Sons of Palawa village is no more.
It's a pity. Even tribals don't deserve to be obliterated because of some alien relic. Those artifacts Zerka found, they must be capable of infecting people, transforming them. I don't know why you'd build a device like that. But some species did, long before humans lived on Tatooine. And the Reclamation Service has the job of bringing those artifacts home. Are you with us?
Sounds like you've got your fire back, Captain.
I had my moment of doubt. I saw Keela, Perrin, and Ban die because of it. What we've just experienced, the artifact powering on the takeover, I'm willing to bet Zerka went through the same thing. If we knew where to start looking for Zerka's base, we could scan for the artifact's power signal, track down the laboratory. Too bad Sylpha didn't get more data.
The base is in the Sand People's cursed land. These drawings should show the way.
This? It's primitive, but it looks like a native map. We'll check its age. Calculate the geographical changes since its creation.
I think we have it, sir. The native's forbidden zone is in Sector 22G. I can start outfitting a probe immediately. Once you're in position, use this signal device to call the droid. It'll launch from here.
In the meantime, we've got friends to bury.
Okay. Oh, there's the boots and gloves that go with the chest piece and the lower robes. Might as well grab them, put it all together at some point. Okay, so where is the signal point? Oh, okay. Deep within the Dune Sea. The thing Circa found. Oh, that quest, regardless if you're playing as a member of the Empire or the Republic, is very familiar. Is there a mailbox out here? There is not. Right. That's fine. Okay, so we are heading north and we're heading into the Dune Sea, which is where we'll take our break. We actually got quite a bit done. Yes, we did miss out on one heroic mission. And there's bound to be another one or two in the Dune Sea. I think there is another outpost you can claim and unlock. Somewhere maybe like around here. It's not the end of the world. I think it might be part of the bonus series, since you don't naturally cross that way. But that's fine. The thing is, might as well talk about it. I don't know when you're meant to do the bonus series of each world. When you complete your tasks on each world, not all the worlds, but most of the worlds, especially early on, have what they call the bonus series, which allow you to complete quests that push on the story of that world after you've completed your main objective, which is where you unlock new areas and such. But I don't know if you're meant to do the bonus series straight after, or maybe at the end of Act 1. It's not something I've really looked into, so I never normally do the bonus series. Also, we have an area up here. If we were in a PvE instance, if we were to travel through this narrow canyon, we'd enter or become instanced for PvP. There is a couple of vendors in there. In fact, I might as well show it off. I think it's the Outlaw's Den. I think it's called the Outlaw's Den. I wonder if there's a vendor here who sells a unique item, which I think you need for a Datacron. You know what? It's been so long. Yeah, the Outlaw's Den. It's a group free for all PvP area. A ghost town whose sad history consists only of conquest, desperation, and despair. Dozens of gangs, pirate crews, and even native raiders have claimed the blighted region over the years, but never for long, as the place seems to attract the criminal element like a lure. So if I open up my map, oh, it's not showing us just yet. You know what, if we, yeah, tell you what, let's go in. Why not? Yeah, the black market trader is just up here. Let's see what the black market trader sells. Oh, we have a security chest over there. Oh, he sells Warzone adrenals, which can boost your damage reduction and your healing. Right. We have a salvager, and there's another black market trader there. What does the salvager have? I'm curious. I mean, apart from the Dune Sea, this is definitely where we would potentially encounter another player from the other faction. Or we could enter the northern section of Jundland and encounter any Republic players as they're doing their quest. We could always go take a look, but I mean, we are currently the only Imperial on the PvP instance. The Berber Seismic Excavator and Scanner. Oh, allows you to excavate HK components. And a wrapped HK transistor. I'll grab that. I don't think we'll ever make use of it, but sure, why not? What do you have for us? A unique mount and adrenals. Okay. The HK series droid. There are many HK models. The most famous, of course, is HK-47. We'll talk more about HK-47 in the future. But at the end of the main storyline, you could salvage pieces of a HK series droid and put it together and make it your companion. You had to go to various worlds and make use of the scanner, I believe, and then excavate the various pieces and reassemble the droid. And now in the Knights of the Fallen Empire expansion, there is another HK series droid. But no matter. I mean, is this bound to legacy? It doesn't say it's bound to anyone. I could just hide in my legacy with my legacy cargo hold. Either way, our experience booster has ran out. So, this is Outpost Zerosh, the final outpost of the Empire here in... on Tatooine. There are smaller encampments which just have like a vendor, like a medical droid. Speaking of medical droids.
Do you require medical attention?
And while we have Outpost Zerosh, players of the Republic have their own walled encampment just there on the map. What we'll do is take a break here.
Hello again.
Hello. So yeah, we'll take a break here. And when we come back, we'll be picking up a few quests here, and then traveling into the Dune Sea. So be it. Thank you all for joining me once again. I know this has been a longer video, similar to the first one. But yeah, I'm quite enjoying my time on Tatooine. As always, feel free to leave a comment if you so wish, and hopefully I'll see you for even more next time. Until then, though, take care. Bye-bye now.